Hey, in this video, you are going to discover how to use Pinterest, which is a huge search engine, to grow your sales on Amazon and generally to grow your Amazon business. And today I'm accompanied by Matt Parker. He's a serial entrepreneur online. He sells on many different marketplaces and he's a coder, developer, and many other things to his name. He has the Pinformative group for people who kind of do Pinterest, want to improve their Pinterest game. I'm part of this group as well. And Matt, maybe you will introduce yourself to us, man, and then we'll dive into the content. Appreciate you coming today.
Yeah, no, thank you. That was a good introduction, actually. I mean, I'll just add a few things to that. Basically, so I started in e-commerce probably 2005, a long time ago now. I started off on eBay, and eventually now I've got to a couple of eBay stores and affiliation, a couple of brands on Amazon, multiple seven-figure brands. I am a WooCommerce developer and coder as well. So from my point of view, I'm kind of looking at things probably a bit more broadly scoped than some of you know, the people who follow this channel. I'm looking at it from outside of e-com rather than just in one lane. So yeah, I started up with the Pinformative group with my partners, Marie over in Washington and Daniel over in Pakistan. And basically we started this global Pinterest agency really with software, analytics, Facebook group. Yeah, that's kind of the route that I've taken. And I've thrown crazily both our seven-figure brands on Amazon and on eBay into the mix, and it's part of the live test case study that we're doing with everything to see what we can do, and it seems to be working. You know, we're getting results. So yeah, I mean, I appreciate you inviting me on, and I'm just going to obviously speak about whatever you asked me in regards to how Pinterest is helping leverage things and how it could work for your people on the channel, really.
Yeah, man, thank you for coming today. I'm excited to talk about this because I've tried Pinterest, and honestly, we were able to bring in traffic, but it didn't convert too much. So I would like to ask you some things about this. Let's first explain to our viewers, what is Pinterest? Like, just in a few words, maybe for those, this is a search engine for those who are not sure, but maybe a few words from you.
I'll give a brief overview quickly because it's probably easy that way. So Pinterest initially started as a marketplace back in 2009, I think it was. And people don't realize that because it's actually viewed as a social media platform, but it's not, in my eyes, it's actually a hybrid. I think it's right in the middle, but we'll go back to that in a minute. But basically started off as a marketplace. People used to shop, but leave things in the cart. For example, I revert to skiing. So say I was skiing and I had some goggles and I bought them, I'd leave them on my cart, I'd leave my jacket. And the guys at Pinterest thought, oh, wow, people are actually buying the things that they're interested in. So then they came up with the concept of pinning. So it actually started off as a marketplace, but it came to fruition that it was pinning. Then you had the boards, and then you had relevant interests. So people who were interested in skiing on one board could cross over and look at someone else who's interested in skiing on their boards. So it's kind of like a cross-marketing platform, but it's developed, I mean, massively over the last two to three years. It floated on the stock, floated in America on the stock markets, and it's just gone up and up. And I think that I think with everything, you know, it's kind of the elephant in the room. I think that the pandemic has blown things up in a massive proportional way. So bottom line is Pinterest, I would say, it has the potential to drive traffic to any marketplace. There's no terms of service really, but they're very ethical, so that's great. So they kind of got that nailed. And I just to summarize what it is, it's kind of like the ultimate place where you can advertise and direct traffic, really. That's the way I look at it, you know. So that's it.
Yeah, pretty cool. So it's like a search engine with visuals, as I know it, right? I'm not as expert as you are in this, but for me it's like a search engine with visuals where we have keywords, and as a part of it, right? We have boards. There's a lot to it, actually, right?
Yeah. I mean, I was, exactly. And I didn't go into technical there. I was just doing a brief overview, but I can go deeper into that. So obviously, like I said, my background is UI interface and multimedia programming. People watching this probably goes, what does that mean? For me, it means that I used to do that years ago. And now what's interesting is that kind of blog bootstrap, it's called, the coding language blogs, came in and knocked all of these animated websites off the internet. You know, you had a lot of Macromedia, which is now Adobe, these really sort of animated dynamic websites, they went off the board. What's happening now is the power of the blog is getting mixed back in with multimedia, because you've got Snapchat, you've got YouTube, as you know, TikTok, but they actually utilize the video algorithm as well. So you've got the power of the blog mixed with the power of media. So now it's kind of like, for me personally, it's like a playground, because Pinterest is an open source multimedia playground where you've got videos which can go viral and pins, a bit like the algorithm on TikTok and Snapchat, where you know somebody can keep watching it, You could have an interest. Say, for example, 80% of the market with at the moment, roughly, that statistic is across the globe, is female market. So, you know, you've got all these females buying on interest, but then it can go viral because it's something that everyone, all these ladies are interested in. And you can target that interest with ads. So you could target a specific person for the product you're selling, which is extremely powerful because you know exactly where they are because they're already interested in it. So you've kind of done the legwork for you. It's just knowing how to do that, how to utilize it, how to, you know, execute that idea and get that to the audience that you want to. So it's kind of like a different way of buying. It's not brand driven, but, you know, at the moment, Marie O'Shea over in Washington, she's content, I call her the queen of content because I think she just blows my mind. But, you know,
how she does it, man, like
but then again she speaks to me and I'm the guy who builds the engine, so it's kind of like a really good partnership we've got going. Because I don't know what she's saying, she doesn't know what I'm saying, but it kind of works. She's written over 50 KDP books. She's got, I know exactly, and I'd rather program working on an algorithm than do that amount of books, you know, each to their own. I heard her shouting out on this group, this big group online, this Amazon group, about free traffic, evergreen traffic, you know, pins that are immortal. And I was like, how can we utilize that? Because I know you were saying, going back to what you just said then about selling, how you didn't get much, you know, maybe not much conversions. It's not just about the conversions. The boards, when you pin to a board on Pinterest, carries a lot of weight with Google. So if you've got pins, which you don't, you know, it's very difficult to break the terms of service, because you could, for example, be a hair care product, you know, supplier. You could do the top 10 tips from, say, Vogue or, I don't know if that's still even a magazine, but you know what I'm saying. Put the top 10 tips, then right at the bottom, stick your product on with a link to Amazon, and you can sell through that blog. And now, even better, you can autonomize those blogs with Jarvis. So you've got automated blogs going onto something that scales on Google with a cross-marketing platform that gives you the freedom to sell on your Amazon products. So it's like there's so many creative ways you can funnel this traffic circular. It's just, you know, there's probably hundreds of thousands, but we're trying to utilize, from our point of view, what we're trying to do is utilize ones that maybe the Amazon market will understand. And we've got the courses, which we're launching hopefully this week, but, you know, it's coming very soon, so that we can help people to understand how they can utilize this traffic, not just for sales, but to put your whole store up there. Because obviously, at the moment, I think we spoke about this off camera. Amazon are giving 10% associated fees back, and you've got, you know, with the affiliated traffic. They're not silly, Amazon. They know full well that that there's a big wide world out there with big commerce, Shopify. I mean, I met a big commerce engineer this weekend at the IRX in Birmingham in the UK. They know there's a big picture going on outside of Amazon, but so does Amazon. They're not silly. So they're saying, how can we reward that? And Pinterest is saying, well, we can give unlimited flows anywhere. So you've also got money on the table for affiliated traffic as well. So it's not just about what is my conversion of sales. It's about what is it going to do across the board. And once you put it on there, it's free. Leave it. Because if you leave it, there's always the opportunity that one of your pins will go viral at any point. So you might have it that an influencer on say, for example, TikTok or Snapchat shouts out something that you're the only person in the country that does that specific thing. And suddenly you put a link on to Pinterest and you've got it going up and your pins are going through the roof. And it's free at the moment. I do advise that you do put advertising placement on that eventually, because we've not really done that with our live seven-figure case study, just because I'm trying to push and see how far we can go with the 0% and then put the ads on. And because it's live, I'm being very wary that I don't end up destroying my staff. And as I put it before, they go home and they're crying in the pillows. You know, you've got to be careful with these things. So you can see my brain is overworking and there's so many things going on, but there really is. It's a really cool open source playground, basically, for me. So I hope that gives you a lot of information.
A lot of information. And I understood many things from this, and hopefully our viewers as well. So you mentioned that we can pin things from, if I understand right, from blogs that we create on Google for our products. Yeah. So if we're selling, like, I always use this example on the channel for some reason, kitchen knives. So the top 10 kitchen knives for 2022, the sharpest or something like that, the most effective kitchen knives for 2022. Yeah. And then there we place our product And we can create these blogs with Jarvis. People who are not aware of what is Jarvis is like software that allows you to write out.
It's like an artificial intelligence blog development. So it'll give you the blogs. You know, you have to be careful. Sometimes it'll throw words in, you know, maybe that shouldn't be in there. But it's great because it's an autonomized system. It's not a linear SOP or anything like that. So it's great. Yeah, exactly.
And then we pin our kind of blog posts to Pinterest, right? And then people on Pinterest can discover these blogs and go to our blogs and buy through clicking on the product on Amazon itself. But I have a question that's honestly a bit complicated. I think for someone who have never done it, if you may, for example, I'm a seller. I have this kitchen knife, my first product maybe, or I have a few knives. That's even better, a brand of knives.
Yeah.
And I want to leverage Pinterest for this and grow my positions on Amazon itself, grow my brand, right? Grow my brand, grow my awareness to the brand. So people will be searching more for my brand, or maybe directly going. So Amazon can reward us with positions because we bring traffic. If it's quality, even if it doesn't convert, I believe it still helps.
Useful.
How should the seller start? Where should you look at? Aside of maybe going to your group, link in the description to get more info. Appreciate good info there, by the way, but what do we do?
Well, I know I'm throwing this in there. I did ask you prior. I just want to make sure that's okay. That I said, we've got the course coming. So that will actually it won't just cover Amazon. It's going to cover merch, KDP. It's going to cover eBay, Etsy. It's not just your crew. There's everybody who can utilize this because like I said, what marketplace or what SM platform in the world can offer a place where you say, will allow you to not have any terms of service in how you cross market. I mean, that's really powerful. And you're right, though, it can be complicated because it's so open. So my job in the Pinformative group was to say, how do we channel this? And I'm building software with engineers to do certain things, but I can't go into that because of NDAs. You know, it's not something I can speak about on camera at the moment. But what I would say is that you can make it simple with these little tests. So for example, if you go onto your product now on Amazon, not on the back end, not on the inventory, but you go onto the products on the front of amazon.com.co.uk, .de, whatever, and you look at it on the right hand side underneath the buy box is the social media buttons, and you've got the Pinterest one there. So all you need to do, it's as simple as this. If you want to just see how it goes, is just pin a few every day, and you click on basically what you do. You click on the Pinterest button. You just sign up with Pinterest. Make sure you've got an account, and to get a business account takes no time at all. Yeah. I mean, you just claim if you've got a URL like an external website, claim that because you get trust with the algorithm. So if you've got an Amazon store and you've got, say, for example, I don't know, WooCommerce, Shopify, BigCommerce, whatever, make sure you claim that as well, because it can help your Amazon listings as well, because it kind of scales everything up on Pinterest. And then all you do, going back to this, is click on that button and it'll pin it for you. It'll pin your Amazon listings to Pinterest.
Yeah.
Done. That's it, pretty much. You can re-evaluate that pin and look at it and maybe change a couple of things. But the metadata is taken directly from Amazon's APIs and put onto Pinterest because they have that link. It's right there. A lot of people miss that, actually. And it's right in your face. It's literally underneath the buy box.
Yeah,
there's like three. You know what I mean, anyway.
There are a few buttons to click, and you can share, I believe, on Facebook, on Pinterest, and something else.
Twitter, I think.
Twitter, right? Yeah, I think
Yeah.
That's what I had in mind as well.
But I'm only pointing that out because so many people are obsessed with winning the buy box that they forget the buttons are underneath it, you know?
Yeah, I see what you mean.
They really do. That's a common little trick, but that's such a simple way of doing it. If you pin five or six or seven things on, okay, this isn't like a huge, massive hidden gem, but you could do that daily, maybe four or five pins. Suddenly, you've got these pins that could be affiliating traffic through flow to your listing, you know, and stick it on a board. Call the board maybe, say you do kitchen knives, for example.
Yeah.
Okay, say we go in the category of kitchen knives on Amazon. You pin all the kitchen knives from Amazon to a board on Pinterest and call it, you know, maybe kitchenware. So, and then create another board, which is kitchen knives, because you might want to do kitchen spoons, you might want to do, utensils. And then what you can do then is share your board with other people. And that again bumps you up. And the boards are the ones that scale with Google. They're the ones that scale, not the pins, it's the boards. Really? So yeah, that's the most important thing to know.
Okay.
So if you get your boards heavy weighted, then you're going to get it up there. It's only going to be great for you, because even if people click through to your Amazon store, Amazon at the moment are giving rewards, not only monetary wise with the 10%, but also they're giving you a thank you and a shake of a hand, because you're directing traffic from all these other places that they know about, and it helps your algorithm on the A9 algorithm. It helps rank you up better and it balances your store up. So there's no proven theory of saying like, okay, how do you prove that that's happening? We've got on our case study, we've got we've basically got data on there, correlated data. And our sales, not this week, but last week, was 141% up, 141% up. And that wasn't anything that was coming through from conversions. That was purely traffic driven, like purely. And we're getting on average 50% increase week on week. We've had to scale it down a little bit because I know we had to employ two internal staff because we do a lot of, we've got a warehouse here. And it's like, to give you an idea, not sounding like egotistical, I'm just trying to give you an idea. It's 3,000 square meter warehouse. And we've got a lot of stock, you know, we got that on the cloud. So we've got our own sort of little thing going on here. Not FBA, but we do FBA, but we've got our SFP, Seller Fulfilled Prime and all that kind of stuff. Because we're dealing with eBay and everything, we've still got all that kind of thing going on. But you have to understand that that traffic, if it's free and if it's traffic, the algorithm likes it, why not just pin a few every so often and see how it goes? You've got nothing to lose. And that's what I would say to your audience is from the baseline is just do that process and see what happens, you know?
Yeah, so if I understood you right, to begin with, just for those who would like to try out Pinterest and see even if anything happens and just to see how it works, then first, you can create an account on Pinterest.com. You can create a business account from this account, which is easy. And I did as well. It took literally a few minutes, I think. You can connect your website, if you have such, to your business account. So it gives you like more authority than kind of it sees like, all right, there's like an actual website and you verify the website, if I'm not mistaken, right? As well, right?
Yeah. That's
and
right,
then
yeah.
Even if you don't have, though, it's all right. You can still repin these, like our product on Amazon under the buy box. There's going to be a few buttons. You can click on the Pinterest button. It will create a pin on Pinterest for that product. Say it's a kitchen knife.
Yeah.
And then we can create a board. It's for those who haven't tried yet. There are boards on Pinterest and you can create a board and fill it with pins. Right? The pins are the little... It's how to explain. It's like a little page on Pinterest that carries and a link to somewhere, right?
I mean, I call it viewports because viewports is responsive. So, you know, you like I've got a cousin and he's got 2 million followers. He's only 13 on TikTok. Yeah, I know. My family's a bit crazy.
I told you this.
Yeah, and he's got an agent and everything. I'm going to try and see if I can get him on the channel, actually. I need to have a word with him. But if you think about TikTok, it's the same. What people have to understand with Pinterest is it's one of the most intricate image algorithms in the world. And they've got like five things going on with the API. I mean, you know, that's why I call it a hybrid. Because if you imagine a spider's web, Pinterest is in the middle. It can throw things out at any marketplace and it's got the same associative algorithm or way that it operates as other places. Like you can put a video on Pinterest, 14 second video is a sweet spot. That video is using the same principle as TikTok and Snapchat because it's actually a 3x2 pin is like a viewport of looking at TikTok, but it's on a board. So it's kind of like I said, it's the ultimate hybrid marketplace that you can play with and it's creative. But what, like I say, us at Pinterest, the Pinformative group, we're trying to streamline that process for every market and say, here's how you can do that. Here's how you can do that. But yeah, it's hard to explain. There's so many dynamics to it. Like you can even buy through pins now on API. So in America, you got a buyable pin. I did a video in our group about how you can put a buyable pin on with Shopify. I know it's not Amazon, but I'm just saying you can pull in the stock without leaving the Pinterest platform. And its conversion is 50% higher than normal when you go on the pin. 50%, depending on the product, obviously, product pending.
So they buy through Pinterest on Shopify? They don't even need to leave the platform.
No,
and they don't trust the platform. So therefore the conversion is crazy, right?
Kind of thing. And they don't even control the stock. So that's why Amazon are like, oh no, this is something we need to get in with this. It does make me wonder, honestly, I'm wondering because there was an affiliate, a partnership going on with Shopify and Amazon, as you probably well know.
And it they stopped now or something. Yeah, broke.
Okay, so my question is, will Amazon be going into the buyable pins? That'd be a cool thing. So you buy, put off the API, but also it'll give freedom to people by not saying, well, Amazon's got our stock control all the time. Pinterest don't believe in that. That's what I'm saying. What Pinterest has done is said, let's do what everyone else isn't doing and make it free to TOS, but like I say, in an ethical way. So it's an interest for me personally. It's like a playground as a coder. That's why I've never really stepped out of my lane. But at the moment, for some unknown reason to myself and my partners, I've kind of gone for it and we're building software. We've got analytical data and started up an agency. And yeah, but I'm enjoying it. That's the main thing. I'm enjoying it. So yeah.
That's pretty cool that you came today to share your knowledge, man. I appreciate it a lot. And I think by now people understand a bit more what it is. And of course, people are welcome to drop comments and ask us things. I'll answer, Matt will answer for sure. Plus, yep. I would recommend you go and click on the link in the description to join the Pinformative Facebook group, because there you can get the information. I believe the case study there is free for people to see how things go, right? So it's so you can actually see how it works. You can ask questions. I've asked questions in this group. I've gotten support. So it's a live group. Like there's real people, you know. So
I'm not just saying this, but it actually is. There's a lot of knowledgeable people in there, not just me, myself, Daniel. We've got panelists as well, because they were interested in learning. But it's kind of like a group where there's not much spam. We all bounce off each other. So yeah, it is. I'm not just saying this because it's like I'm part of it, but it is. I'm really kind of proud of the group, of how they answer each other and bounce off each other. So yeah, anybody who wants to join, that'd be cool. Appreciate it.
Yeah, man. So we'll link it in the description. And also I want to say that in Pinterest, how we've gotten the traffic, at least, we created pins and boards based on search. So in this platform, people also search for stuff. So they search for kitchen knife, stainless steel, kitchen knife, gift, something like that. And then they get to a search page where they see many pins, which usually carry either, it's like a picture, or it can be a video, right? And based on keywords, if you create your pin pretty much like a description of a product on Amazon, so you have the title, you have the description, and you fill it with keywords, then you can rank for these keywords. That's what we found. That's how we drove the traffic. And what do you think about it?
I was at Seller Sessions in London this week, last weekend, and I kind of dropped a bomb as well, because I did a live feed and I said, the thing is, what we believe is that it's not just about keywords, it's about content refresh. That's why video algorithms are ranking quite well, whether it's Penguin with Google, you've got your video algorithm with Amazon. You know, videos have a really high refresh metadata rate, because if you think about every frame, for example, in America, you've got NTSC, 25 frames a second, the amount of data in one frame, it's crazy. So it's kind of like, and it ranks, and that's why. So, you know, it's interesting, because there's so many ways that you could do this. You could create a video. I mean, there are ways to pin as well on schedule. You can, I mean, we've affiliated up with Tailwind and Canva. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So people can go on there. If you want to go, you know, have a try on it and it's working, you might want to start sort of systematically doing it with the repinning schedule. You can go on Tailwind, or you've got Canva, and Canva can create pins, you know, the actual visuals for the pins as well, quite, you know, quite efficiently. So yeah, there's a lot more going on than meets the eye with Pinterest. They actually have a huge involvement investment in the image algorithm team. It's probably is the most sophisticated one on earth, because it doesn't just look at keywords. It looks at the image, even with filters like saturation, and it assesses, you know, what kind of watch you've got on with the keywords, and says, okay, This kind of watch is a bit blurred, but I know it's that brand, so that will work with that keyword, and it'll rank it up. Wow. So it's there's a lot more than that going on, but I don't want to mess up the audience by saying too much. I'm just trying to give you an understanding that image isn't just about lifestyle images with Pinterest. We've done a lot of research with engineers. It's about, and there's much more depth to it in regards to what is in the image. And for example, you probably heard of Google Lens, that kind of thing. So it's looking all
where they scan, happy guy, you know, like muscular or something like that, right? Or red color in the background, right? That's what you mean. Scans the image, say.
Exactly. Right? Yeah, exactly. So say you've got an image of I think in one of my videos, it was like a picture of some food. In the keywords, you put sushi. If you put green, because it can read the color green, it's vibrant enough, it'll key that up as well. So, you know, everything is readable on the algorithm, which is insane. And they're constantly working on, for example, if you've got a filter, going because we've got affiliation with Adobe as well, but say you've got a filter from the Adobe suite on Photoshop, it's starting to be able to read through that as well and go, okay, well, this is actually sushi. We've seen this before. It's got a bit of a, you know, bit of a filter on it, but we know it's sushi and we've figured that out. And that's what it's doing all the time, learning.
It learns constantly upon learning on what it learned, so it can learn more. And man, that's crazy.
It is crazy. It really is crazy.
So what I understand, Matt, from our talk is, first, it seems like you mentioned video, which is, you mentioned that it's heavy, right? And because we can create videos in different platforms, even though, for example, YouTube is dedicated to video, but for in platforms that are not that 100% video, the video carries more weight and therefore it can be pushed higher by the algo just because of that, right?
Yeah, definitely. One of the it's like me and you now. I mean, I don't know, have you got any boards on there for your YouTube channel? Because have you considered...
I have started, recently. We have started working on that,
So so you could pin 14-second stints on there of each individual cast that you've had and link it back to YouTube, but you can also link it to a product on Amazon. That's how crazy it is, you know? So you can do... This is what I'm trying to say. If you've got a video like TikTok or Snapchat that can go viral and it's 14 seconds... on Pinterest with your sellable link going anywhere, it doesn't just have to be Amazon, it could be eBay, Etsy, but you know, wherever, suddenly you know you've dragged them in with a high ranking video because of the algorithm, but also you've got the link on there to sell your products. It's what I'm trying to get across to the audience is the for me personally, what I believe is the ultimate cross-marketing creative platform in the world. I how can you beat that? Eventually, it's just like you can do anything you want. It's just understanding it and how you can direct that in a really logical manner, you know.
And man, before we wrap it up, man, maybe you'll give us one ninja tip, please, to our viewers in terms of like, you know, you have many probably tips to share, but for example, maybe for those who are already doing Pinterest and they have some boards, or for those who are listening and will go check your group or just go to Google and check Pinterest, how should we at least look at that in order to grow our business on Amazon? Like create more content, create pins consistently, or what do you think? Like what would be one thing you kind of will?
I've got a few in my head. I've got a few of them in my head, but I would say is I'm trying to think of a good one now.
I know it's kind of a tricky
the sweet spot that the algorithm likes is between 10 and 15 pins daily. If you've not got that many products, it would be advised to put one or two products on, but don't place any adverts on those products until after 4 months minimum.
What is adverts?
Ads, you've got ads. Pinterest ads, because the ads on Pinterest are way more cheaper than... This is why we're trying to do this. We're trying to redistribute PPC for the agencies as well, because if they're getting high PPC ratios, we're trying to lower that down through the power of Pinterest, but then the PPC agencies aren't losing out. They can redistribute that PPC money somewhere else within the dropshipping account. So it's kind of like you've got $18 a click on some items. Imagine if you could do it at $0.5 a click and get hold of that extra $15 and throw it on items that actually would benefit from it as an agency on Amazon itself rather than, or Google or whatever, you know, that's what it's about. So all I'd say is 10 to 15 pins a day is what Pinterest likes. Repinning one to two a day is a big thing. Repinning, because when you repin to somebody else's board, they see you. And I would say if you can just take 30 minutes a day out and do that process, 15 to 10 a day, maybe one to two repins a day, you'll find that traffic flow will eventually rank your boards up on Google and push your store up there with your listings. So that's it, really.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, man. That's actionable stuff to do, because maybe people are like, well, I'm not sure how many pins should I create? Like, I mean, it's honestly, 10 is not easy if you're like a solopreneur, you know, you have like one, two products and like, whoa, I need to create 10, but at least do something, right? At least.
Well, or you've got what? You're completely right. And I'm sorry to cut you up, because you've got a valid point. I was thinking that as I was saying it. So if you've got one product, for example.
Yeah, just for beginners, for example.
You can still utilize that. Mm-hmm. What you can do is pin that product. But also what I said, do a blog. Look into blogs. Do a blog, because you can unlimitedly pin from one blog. So you could do 20 blogs and repin them to that one blog with your product on. So it's almost like you've got one item on Amazon, but you've got 50 of it on Pinterest for traffic flow.
Yeah. And then
bang, 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 all in one product. That's where you're actually creating 50 products off one product, really, in theory.
And then eventually they lead to the product on Amazon, right?
Yeah. Right. Just with one link. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So you just got to be a bit creative, maybe trial and error it. But I think with probably if you've got one product, it could work in your favor massively just by trial and error, because obviously you've not got that big amount of massive ASINs or SKUs to deal with. So you might find you get better results in being more diversified with your approach to it.
Also, would be a good idea probably to kind of check with any keyword tracking software people are using to where your keywords are initially, and then when you start, just see how it improves them, right? Like then you can say, or it's hard to track, really.
You can do. It's hard to track, but my advice is you know, theoretically, what you want to do is look at Google keywords. Why? Because they're the ones that are going to rank. People say, oh, you know, there's not much on Pinterest in regards to tracking keywords. There's not really. That will get better over time. But if you look at Google keywords, they're the ones that are going to have affiliation with your boards. So that's why I believe it's more important looking at Google keywords, because they're the ones that are going to push your boards up the ranking. And they're the ones who indefinitely are going to push the traffic towards your listings on Amazon. So I would definitely look at Google keywords in affiliation with the Pinterest boards.
That means if we have a board that's ranking on Google, say again, kitchen knife, right? People type into Google kitchen knife, stainless steel, they will see maybe on page one or two, maybe it's going to climb up. Yeah. They're going to see what? They're going to see the board ranking there or the pin. And then they can click on this link on Google to go to Pinterest, and then they'll read more. And there's going to be the link to Amazon. And because all this is going to work simultaneously, I believe many keywords on Google itself are going to go up. Many pins on Pinterest are going to go up. And maybe the traffic will eventually come to Amazon, if I understand right.
Yeah, you're correct. I mean, the thing is as well, like I said, it's 0% without ads at the moment. Traffic flow is free. So that won't last forever, though, you know, from experience. So that's why I'm saying now's the time that I'm jumping in, because I've done e-commerce for 15 years. I've seen the rise, not fall, but I've seen the rise and schism of eBay and PayPal when Amazon was nothing. Now I'm seeing Amazon, it's gone up, and then they've got high PPC ratios. So I'm a firm believer in the beast grows, but it never gets any bigger than a certain size. The world is only a certain size. So at the moment, I think that Amazon, I wouldn't say it's gone to its maximum potential, especially with some categories, but I think that because of the PPC rates that they put on there, in theory, I mean, you like I was saying to you prior to this video, you've got somebody who's paying 98 cents for one click. They could be paying 12 cents for Google affiliated traffic, and Amazon's still getting that hit. And it's helping agencies for more longevity and clients as well, you know. It makes sense, because if you're doing like the, I call it the traffic warden sort of hit and run. So you like, you start hitting them with a high PPC, and then suddenly they're not a client because they can't afford it. Wouldn't that be better? So they've got something more sustainable. And that's why I'm doing this, because I think that it's something maybe that's needed by all of e-commerce, not just Amazon, eBay, Etsy, everywhere, you know. So that's why I'm doing it, really.
Because the traffic there is it's free for now on Pinterest. You can create free traffic, and also you can run cheap ads. Compare it with Amazon, say.
Yeah, exactly. So you're going to save money on the cheap ads instead of paying Amazon. But Amazon are saying, we want that traffic because it's going elsewhere anyway, to Shopify, etc., or BigCommerce, or, you know, Magento, or, you know, there's others. And I think that it's a good move from Amazon. I mean, why wouldn't you incentivize that when you know it's already there?
So you're saying, like, for example, again, a kitchen knife, we advertise it. I've never done it. I'm painting the picture in my mind, hopefully in the minds of the viewers as well. Using ads to show your pin against keywords on Pinterest or against boards, maybe. And then it's cheaper probably than Amazon. And for example, people see that, oh, it's a kitchen knife, and the link is going to lead to Amazon. So you're getting a 12 cent click to the product kitchen knife instead of paying $1.50 on top of search of kitchen knife on Amazon, something like that, right? And then.
If
that's broad, like, not diving deep into the strategy, but something like that.
I mean, ultimately, there's so many diversified ways of doing it. I mean, 100%. We could go into it, but I'm sorry to be rude, but I'm going to have to go in a minute. I hate saying that. I know we said half an hour. It's just because I have wife and kids, and I think they're going to be annoyed at me.
And that's why we're going to link your Facebook group in the description and your socials.
Honestly, Volva, it's been a pleasure, and I really appreciate you bringing me on today. Sorry to cut this short. It's just I'm going to be elsewhere. But it's been amazing, and I hope that hopefully that your viewers get some value from this, you know, going forwards, and maybe they understand Pinterest more, and I wouldn't mind maybe start talking to you again in the future when we get further down the line with the live case study. It'd be interesting to see where we had, you know, end up basically. So
thank you, man. Thank you for coming today. I'll leave all the links in the description for viewers to your groups, to your socials, and thank you a lot, man. Appreciate it.